What's good, YouTube? It's your girl, Miss Golden 83, and I am here to do a word from the ancestor reading for the sign of Capricorn. Okay, Capricorn, this is your last reading for the week. Okay, hope you guys are doing well. All right, remember you guys, these are general messages, not personal. So take what resonates and pass the rest to the next. Okay, at this time, you can go ahead and grab you a piece of paper and pen if you like, so that way you can do your own interpretation through this reading. This is the Soul Cards 2 deck for anyone who is new to the channel and has not experienced the Tapping to Your Soul readings, okay? Soul Card 2 deck is illustrated by Deborah Kauf Chapman. There is no book to this. This is fully intuitive reads, okay? And so I usually just pull three cards, top, bottom, and middle, and that is for your past, present, and future energy, okay? And so, and then we look at the bottom of the deck for your overall outcome. What you can do is answer the questions associated to each placement for yourself as you look at the imagery, how it makes you feel as you answer the question. And then if you like, based off of your situation at this time, you can go ahead and write what you would like your overall outcome to be, okay? So with that being said, let's go ahead and get into it. Capricorn, okay, we have one from the top, one from the bottom, which is your present. This is from the top. The top card is your past energy, and then one energetically from the middle. For your future energy, okay? And then we'll look at the bottom of the deck for your overall outcome. Like I said, if you like, go ahead and write out what you would like your outcome to be based off of where you are presently, okay? So with that being said, we're not gonna flip over all the cards at one time, as that's too much energy to read. I like to go a little bit at a time, one at a time, so that way you can have time to really write things down. Feel free to pause if you need to write out what you feel, okay? So to start off, we're gonna start with your past energy. What held you back in the past, Capricorn? What held you back in the past, okay? This card came out in Aries reading, but it was in there overall, under, it was on the bottom of the deck, okay? This card has came out before in this placement, I believe. I just can't remember which sign it was, okay? But nonetheless, take the time to really look at this card, how it makes you feel as you think of what held you back in the past, okay? Taking the time to really sit in your energy, Capricorn. With this card, kind of looking at the imagery, they are holding their hands up and kind of ignoring something, okay? What was it that you possibly could have been ignoring in the past? There's something you were ignoring in the past or not willing to accept in the past, okay? Maybe someone's advances towards you. You could have acted a little shallow possibly to someone in the past, okay? Is what I'm feeling when looking at this card. For some, it could have had something to do with, I'm also hearing avoidance, okay? Maybe not wanting to hear something, okay? Which could have been constructive criticism that someone was giving you or advice, and you constantly used to say, "Oh no, I can do it. I'm good. I don't need any help. I'm good. I know what I'm doing." In all actuality, maybe you didn't, okay? Like I said, could have possibly pushed away someone in the past out of shallowness, okay? I don't know why, but it's coming, that's what's coming through, okay? And maybe that, not accepting that person or accepting that criticism or that advice, possibly is what held you back in the past. Okay, and in doing so, could have possibly changed your life. Okay, it could have stunted your maturity. It could have stunted a friendship. Okay, could have changed someone's perspective on you. In a different way, somehow. Okay, because maybe you wouldn't have went through a certain pain if you possibly would have listened to that person or accepted their advances. Okay? Maybe your life would be different now had you taken the time to actually listen instead of push away. Okay? So that is all that I have for that. Let's move on to the present energy, okay? What continues to hold you back presently? What continues to hold you back presently? Okay. This card, same placement, Virgo. Okay? You may have Virgo in your chart, okay? Same as with Aries, I stated, you guys might want to go and look up birth charts, what they do, how they work. And if you look at any of the readings from last week, you can go there just to any of the zodiac signs from last week. And you can find a link to a very reputable birth chart astrologer. By the name of Yasmine Bland, who I've gotten a birth chart from. It is called a free horoscope chart, okay? But it is a birth chart. And it is very insightful, okay? So that way you can learn your birth chart placement, Sun, Moon, and Venus. And then within the rest of the chart, it's primarily talking about the different houses, which are certain attributes and characteristics. That you were possibly born with, okay, and are associated with different zodiac signs, okay? And so it helps you understand why you are the way you are with your career, or how what your work ethic is, okay? Things of that nature. So take the time to do your research about it before you go and do it, but I highly recommend it, okay? Especially if you're looking for some insight, okay? Which is what I feel for you is what this card is stating, okay? Is needing some form of insight, okay? You're in your head a lot. You're trying to reach some form of enlightenment, okay? Or awakening. You need to awaken in some shape, form, or fashion. As this person in this card, to me, looks somewhat decayed, okay, but is still trying to grow some shape, form, or fashion, okay? You could come from a place of, like I said in the past, choosing your own way, feeling like you don't need any help, that you know what you're doing, okay? All of us at some point in time need help with something, but maybe you just don't like being dependent on other people. That could just be what the case is, and there's nothing wrong with that, okay? Until it becomes kind of, if you think of all your readings this week, somewhat circling around love, okay? You are somewhat dependent on that, okay? But nonetheless, you're trying to experience presently some form of awakening, okay? But somehow you're not able to reach it. It doesn't feel like it's reachable to you because you're focusing on, there's something else that you're focusing on more so than anything. Instead of focusing on yourself and kind of bringing your own self to life, okay? You want another person to help you do it, okay? Which is somewhat like a form of codependency, if you will, okay? And it could be someone in particular that you usually go to, and it's possible that that person is not available to help you with it, okay? Or they've tried and you push them away, okay? So it's now fallen on you to enlighten yourself, okay? The best thing to do is just, as I stated in your readings this week, is really evaluate yourself, Capricorn, and the type of person that you want to be and what you have done in the past and how you can change it, okay? Which falls into the next placement of how will you change your future? Okay, which is on this card here. And I saw this card when I started beginning readings today. I thought it was going to come out for Virgo, but it didn't. But I felt like this card was going to come out, and it's only because of the fact that it came out in multiple readings. Okay, Taurus has gotten this card. Virgo has gotten this card before, but of course in a different placement. Okay. For you, I want you to really look at it and ask yourself, how will you change your future, okay? And if you really look at the difference between this card, both kind of replicate the same thing, but this one looks a little bit more lively as there's more color. This one is more decayed, okay? You're seeking enlightenment now. Something is going to awaken in you, okay? Both have something, you know, blossoming or coming out from the third eye. And you see here, if you look really closely, there's like this little orange burst in the middle there, okay? For this to be in your future placement now, usually if it's somewhere else, such as your present or past, I usually evaluate it as overthinking, okay? For you, being in the future placement is some form of awakening, okay? Which I feel like with this whirlwind going around mountains behind here, the eyes are closed, okay? Your mind's eye and your crown chakra are going to be awakened as you take the time, like I said, to really review your life. Okay, and figure out what changes need to be made. Okay, something needs to change. Like I said, this orange little burst, it almost looks like either a flame or a flower. I feel like it's like a flower in a sense. Okay, and it's just constantly a whirlwind of possibly past memories that you have as well that will kind of give you a better understanding, okay? Pay attention to your dreams. Capricorn, there could be some hidden meaning there, okay? Start doing maybe some research on dream analysis, such as pay attention to if you see certain animals in your dreams, if you see certain colors in your dreams, places or things such as mountains, okay? And kind of just start doing your own dream analysis, okay? But when you're doing it, make sure you take the time to realize how you feel when you're seeing certain things in your dreams, okay? And write them out so that way you can better kind of analyze them for yourself, okay? So with that being said, Capricorns, let's see where you are with your overall outcome at the bottom of the deck, okay? And this is your overall outcome, okay? We have a snake here that's kind of looking at this person's mind, which is, you know, on fire, okay? It's kind of like flamed. And it sees the snake, it observes the snake, it knows that it's there, okay? So, and he's not afraid of the snake. His hands are even in a very calm place, okay? I feel like for your final outcome, Capricorn, you're gonna know what your demons are. You're gonna be aware of your demons, your inner demons, okay? And protect your mind from them, okay? Once you extract the negative from your mindset or the chaos that, you know, may be going on within you, you'll be able to confront it, okay? You'll be able to know who's for you and who's not, in a sense of your personal growth and your self-improvement, who you need around you, okay? I feel like if your demon is accountability, I think you will start taking accountability for your own actions. If it's not in reference to anyone else, it could just be your own internal demons, okay? And so protecting your mind from that, in a sense of actually confronting it as the snake is right here, okay? Confronting it, knowing that it's there, not using external vices to suppress the demon, okay? Like drinking, smoking, stress eating, sex, those type of things, okay? Sometimes we have the tendency of doing that, okay? Suppressing with things that we know are bad for you. That imparts to the demons, the internal demons within, okay? We all have done it. Sometimes we only do it because we're trying to reach that next level of unconsciousness, if you will, okay? Sometimes we take things just a little bit too far. Other times it's just, again, trying to suppress, okay? And I have done that in the past as well. It does not help because those demons can still be there. You have to confront them. You have to understand them. You have to move as they move and then extract them, okay? And prevent them from coming back in, okay? Especially once you've healed from them. Once you've healed and you protect yourself, there's no way that they can interfere and change who you are ever again, okay? So it's that time to do that, okay? So Capricorn, that is really all that I have for you guys, okay? I will be out for the rest of the month as I have completed all 12 signs by the time you see this, and I usually do that and take the rest of the month off to clear the energy of the readings from all the readings for the month, and so that way it gives you guys time to really clean your energy as well, okay? Whatever negative energy or toxic or karmic energy is around you, okay, leave that in May, okay? Really reevaluate yourself, okay, and come back in June with a new spirit, with a new positive and open-minded energy, and take that on with you moving forward through the rest of the year or your life, really. Okay, it's time for a change. Okay, so with that being said, Capricorns, that's all that I have for you guys. Until next month, peace.